Well, we're gonna try to sail through this here. What is, it's not the wrong agenda, it's not the agenda, hang on. Hang on. Hey, Carolyn. I have to find it down in here.
Oh, we're going back, and do we have welfare?
We didn't open welfare. I didn't open the meeting, really.
Oh, all right, so open the meeting, because that was a non-meeting.
Are you on a countdown now?
I am.
Yeah, she is. All right, I'm gonna call for the select board meeting of February 20th at 7:03. And so we're going to.
I'll move that we go into non-public session.
Thank you.
Purpose of dealing with welfare petitions.
Second.
Roll call, Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne? Yes. Meeting, Caroline, who's the most, I can speak to Michelle Parker, she's like you didn't mean. Okay.
Thank you.
That's a big message.
We're gonna sign the warrant again, please, I hope the board will sign the warrant again. Did, how many copies did we sign the last time? Was it two, one original or two originals?
I think just one original, and I scanned it.
Oh, okay, so we'll just do the same thing. All right, so, all right, board, so that conversation is because, you know, in the process of trying.
Why don't we figure, finish welfare first? So.
Wonderful idea, thank you, Michael.
So, just before we forget about it. In the case of welfare case 2018-002, board is recommending $750 in rental assistance and $50 in gas card assistance. And case 2018-003, assistance with electrical costs up to $300.
Second. Any discussion? Well, those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Carolyn.
Are you good?
I think we're good.
Okay.
Let's just go to the warrant.
Have a good night.
Yeah, me too. So, in order to get the budget to print on the 737, which is the official budget form through the tax pool.
Right.
Since the budget committee meeting, I've been in this ongoing iterative process.
Tax.
Yes, yes. Because we don't talk to our tax, we don't talk to our DRA contact directly. We talk via the portal. It's an iterative process. I make a change. I hear back the next day, day and a half, whatever, you know. So I've had to make some changes. So some of them are don't really impact us. They were just accounting, the chart of accounts. She wanted something on this line rather than that line. She wanted something to be called one thing, not the other thing. So then those are simple. But we changed two warrants. All right, so Article 11, Conservation Land Trust Fund Capital Reserve Fund.
Yeah.
To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $10,000 to be added to the Conservation Land Trust Capital Reserve Fund. $10,000 will be transferred from the land use change tax fund to fund this appropriation, period.
Yeah.
The original warrant had something about, well, you know, otherwise, if it isn't there, we'll take it from fund balance.
Oh,
she
right.
Says, take that out of there.
Yeah, that wasn't how it was supposed to be worded.
Correct. Now, this is how it's been worded for the last 20 years, but I said, okay, aye aye, Captain, take it right out. Then the other one was, the road resurfacing was an article from hell. So she asked questions, is it a petition? Yes.
Yeah, clearly.
Yeah, yes, it is. This, that, and the other thing. And then, you know, a day or so later, she says, well, this has to be, I have an you have to classify each of these things?
Yeah.
You don't see it. It's not here.
Right.
It's just in the portal. So I had it as a, and these have RSA meanings.
Right.
It was an individual warrant article. She says, well, because it's a petition, it really has to be a special warrant article according to RSA, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
So the only way that you can make it that is to delete the original and put it in the new one.
Put it in again? Okay.
So I did that.
Yes.
And then iteration, whatever iteration we're on, day and a half later,
right.
She says, well, you really should put the by petition in the text block of the warrant.
Okay.
All right, Captain. So that's where we stand. I haven't gotten the all
so
clear.
It hasn't changed. It just says by petition in a different spot?
It says it now twice, well, it says it twice.
Okay, twice, okay.
It says it twice.
All right.
The one that did change is Article 11, but not substantively, so.
Right, took out the. But that's the select board warrant anyway, so.
It's just, yes.
Why doesn't she want in Article 16 with the Historical Society? Don't rock the boat.
Judy asked me the same question. I don't know why she didn't, so.
Do what the DRA tells her, I guess.
So I'm hoping she doesn't come back and do the same thing.
What is by petition, why should, it should just say that, right, yeah.
It does say, it does.
No, I know, but why isn't it down here too, or in the second place, that's nuts.
She didn't object to that one, she objected to this one.
Maybe she hasn't gotten to it yet. She hasn't checked it yet, you're gonna, we're gonna sign it, she gotta check it.
Could be, what I hope. So board.
Maybe you should put that in too.
Well, I don't wanna, I have to put it in the, I have to change the tax board, it's okay.
Oh, okay.
So here's what I'm assuming that the tax war, as that our warrant, as it now exists in the tax portal, and as you see before you, it's not gonna change again.
Right.
So with that in mind, I'd like us to sign this.
Sure, and it hasn't changed, it's just.
So it could be 16 and 17.
Pardon?
It could be 16 and 17, she comes back out.
Yeah, but one doesn't have money, it's because it had money.
Okay.
Well, 17 does, right, and not the.
Not 17, 16 does, yes, but maybe it was the source of the money, maybe it was money coming from a, the balance sheet, I don't know, I don't know.
I don't know.
So I think we just need to sign one based on what.
Well, yeah, the next week we'll sign that one.
I mean, one copy, and I'm gonna initial it, and it does say the 20th of February, which is today.
Thank you for dealing with the tax portal.
Oh, Lord. Yes.
I thought this was supposed to streamline things.
I was just gonna say that, it made all of our lives easier is what it was supposed to do, right?
It is.
Well, it makes mine and Mike's life easier.
It is a piece of software that looks like it was developed with tools of like 15, 20 years.
Yeah.
That's about right.
The system.
It's not quite that, but, you know, it doesn't have any of the, you have to keep clicking, 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 it's just not, there's no finesse, there's no finesse at all.
I'm sure the Secretary of State does that.
Well, maybe.
Click on things, it just opens PDFs. It stays on, some departments are much better than others.
So, you know, at this point, we have to have this budget and warrant posted next Monday, the same.
It's open, they don't make you change it again.
Yes.
I'm around all weekend.
Well, if there's another change, yeah, if there's another change.
All right.
All right, so while you're signing, we're getting information on voter's guide mailing, there actually may be PO somewhere in one of these folders.
Yeah.
Okay, there's, annual town report, or we have to have it published by March 6th, though, so our town clerk is patiently waiting for some stuff from us. Charlie's coming next Monday to review the warrant with us.
Okay.
I'm still tussling with the portal.
Thank you.
I have no additions or updates to the childcare at this point, I think we have two people.
Think we do, right?
Yes.
I'll say cancel.
I've reached out to the Caroline.
Can you put this in the folder that Caroline's going to get, please, so that she can scan it?
I've reached out to daycares and everything, so.
Okay, excellent. So Oak Street complaint, this is someone who's, who fell into a pothole, Huh?
They're carded, not needed. Right.
So I never know exactly what our liability is with this. You know, they were asking us to pay something out there, remember, I think we don't, it's just one of those things, right? So should we ask Caroline to draft a response?
Right, so there's an email from Caroline earlier today, wrote from Primex, their liability company, that said that should we choose, we could submit the claim to them on this, I don't know the woman's name, on the resident's, or I don't even know the resident, the person's behalf, which will be denied.
Oh, okay.
And then Primex sends the statute that tells them why they're being denied.
Okay.
Because the towns and cities don't have liability, unless it's gross negligence and the road is being repaired, so I don't know how we have showed gross negligence.
So we can do it that way, if you want to.
Yeah, that's fine, because it said that Dover has, they have submitted it for Dover already, denied 7 of them for Oak Street.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly, was it 7, I can remember the number, but yeah, but it's.
All right, very good, let's do that.
Because there were cones and everything out there that said, you know.
Okay, that sounds good.
There is now a Department of Labor hearing scheduled for March 7th at 9:45 for Jeff St. Jean and his. Yep, it's a Wednesday, and his quest to get compensatory pay for those 5 days. So, you know, based on what, you know, we heard, we could have legal counsel. I would just assume one of us do it and let the chips fall where they may, unless you have a different thought.
So, 7th of March, my calendar is not up to date, that's all 2 weeks away, so. My work calendar is not up to date, I don't know, I mean, I'm in Concord every day, so. But it depends on, what time is that, 9:45?
Yes.
If I don't have another legal hearing after that, I could go, if you want me to, but.
We could coach you.
Not worried about that, I'm just, I'll say yes now, but I mean, with the caveat that I may have to cancel the week before, that's when the legislative calendars come out on Friday, so I know.
So you would know by the second?
I would, you know, actually, the fact that it's, I wouldn't know by the second, yes.
Okay, so I'll try to find coverage if you can't, so.
Oh, great, thank you.
So I'll try to find coverage.
It's March 7th.
And I'll let you guys know, I'll work on that tomorrow, I'll call.
But we should talk to, call the Department of Labor and ask if we should have, we're supposed to have legal representation or we can handle it ourselves, they'll let you know. What usually happens, I mean.
We'll do it either way.
None of us are attorneys, so if you show up with legal representation.
Worst that happens is he spent money to get $900 and.
Fair enough, we pay $900. Okay.
Yeah, an hour there, with our legal counsel, and an hour back.
That's a lot of money.
Yeah, for sure.
$900, so.
You know, we might, you know, call, you know, what's his name, but he wanted some coaching.
Do we know, did you say where was that?
I think the letter is.
Is there a letter on there?
I think so, it came through.
I did not see that.
Part of my calendar, I'm assuming you left that by, on, yeah, say, last year, I don't remember what the. Or if it's up Fruit Street or the other street that goes by Pleasant Street. One or two. And whatever it is. I have to go there for that complex for one thing.
No cancellation within 1 week of hearing, except for an emergency. Weekly unpaid wages, weekly unpaid vacation and sick time, unpaid
what?
Compensation, and payment of salaried employees unpaid. It's four issues now.
The DOL, Pleasant Street. That's that open answer. I already made the right name. You're the one who's named. Aren't you lucky? Sorry.
He's going to be retired.
I am.
Any party has the right to have representation by an attorney at the party's own expense. All right, well, we can think about this in a minute or two when it's coming up.
I put it in my calendar either way, so okay. I'm happy to go through it.
All right.
We'll have to have a
we can talk about the issues, yeah. I don't think we can do that tonight, though. I'm just not prepared. I do have transfer station request. I don't see you.
Yeah, there was an email that came in. Yeah. So there's a gentleman,
you know,
I read it, yeah,
okay,
I read it
yeah,
when I was sitting here before the meeting started. So there's a gentleman that has a studio of some, a space of some kind in the mills, and he has two air conditioners he would like to dispose of, like small window units, in an environmentally friendly way, apparently. So he was wondering, and there is actually a way that he can do this, whether he can get a special permit to use the transfer station for one time. I think it's like 25, pointing at the imaginary thing that comes out of the ordinance. I think it was, we looked at it a couple weeks ago for someone else, a different issue that I saw, that it's like $25 or something.
Plus the?
Plus the disposal fee, so it's like, I don't know what we charge for our air conditioner now, but.
I'm supposed to know that, like that.
Well, we have.
So the answer is yes, there is a mechanism that we, that this man can't do this.
Okay, so we can have Caroline, all right, so we can have Caroline send him a letter or contact him?
Yeah, as long as he pays the relevant fees, I mean. He said he could just throw it in the dumpster at the mills, but he doesn't feel that's the right thing to do, so.
Okay, all right. Okey-dokey. Well, that's all I have, so then there's just folder work.
I have two, well, I can wait for her to do that.
Go ahead.
So we have reimbursement for Kelly Anderson to the rec department for basketball rep. Happy to sign the check as soon as you're signing it.
I already signed it, this is old.
Oh, well then, I'll sign it.
Here.
Well, she was including that, I think, with the check, so that you would know you'd be able to sign it up.
Holding for her.
Yes.
You signed this one too?
Why not?
Didn't she just tell me that, they were signed? Never mind.
Okay.
She could have had them while she was still here.
Okay, this one's permanent transportation, interim inspection of municipally owned bridges, for Olin Lane Bridge, over Rowan. And recommended posting of no weight or height posting required in Olin Lane Bridge posting, but no action is required by the town because it is a temporary bridge. And temporary bridge do not require weight limit postings, and one lane bridge signs required for temporary bridge. So.
A waste of resources, sign up. Seriously, so they sent us a letter telling us we have to do something, but oh, by the way, you don't have to do a bigger exempt.
Right, it's the rep list and bridge list that comes out every year, so.
Yeah, that's very nice.
All right, would you like to look out? As far as I know, we're still on the, bridge list for.
Okay. Notes.
Notes?
Who's taking notes?
What did we just do? Did we do anything? Just correspondence. I assume this is correspondence. That I have. I have that.
DOT's correspondence on the Old Mill Lane.
Yeah.
Okay, purchase order, move to accept purchase order 1381 to B&B Printing.
1381?
1381.
Okay.
To B&B Printing for voter guide printing up to $400.
Sorry.
Wait a second.
Yes.
Oh, sorry.
She moved. I seconded.
I'm not used to this. Okay, I'll call the question. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Move to accept purchase order 1380 to Digital Inc. for 2,000 residence tax cards.
For how much?
$248.45.
Okay, any discussion? Those in favor say aye.
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 We'll keep you going. Very long in the state.
It's already started, thank you.
All right.
You've got the signed warrant back in there, right?
Yes, this is the signed warrant, that's the.
This is just an extra. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, this is your road safety audit application for, I'm assuming, report?
Yeah, we'll talk, we'll put it on and talk about it some other time, if that's all right.
The next one is fine.
Seventeen, eighteen. Seco Stormwater Coalition member contact list? So. So, agreement of professional planning assistance.
I think they're wanting us to do something, we should take a look at that for next week.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Seco Stormwater Coalition? Do you have it posted?
I'm just gonna write on.
Yeah, please review for next week.
Memorandum of understanding between Dover and Rollinsford, this is what we signed the other day.
We didn't sign it.
Did you change it?
This is the fully ex, should be, no, we should have the fully executed one.
It's not signed.
So, forget that then, somewhere I think Caroline said we have the fully executed.
You're looking. Office of Legal Counsel, Dover.
That could be for.
Fully executed winter road maintenance agreement, is this what you're looking for?
So it should have our signatures. And theirs.
There's our signatures, there's theirs.
Yeah, so that's fully executed, just filed, which is.
Okay.
What is the rest of that say? Well, that was our resolution for the boundaries, oh, and they're voting on the resolution. Nobody voted no. Oh, and the Dover City Council voted no.
They have pity on us, that's not enough, thank you, Dover. Department of Revenue Administration. Monitoring evaluations and supporting municipalities, November 16th, 2016. The DRA received same contract between town and Rollinsford and Avatar.
Okay.
Samples. Is this just the same report that says they did a good job?
Their audit, yeah, I think it's their audit result.
Didn't we already see this?
I thought so.
Okay.
It'd just be, it's coming through again.
Okay, that's the hearing we already talked about.
Why is that in there?
I don't know. Okay, we have Townsend Bill?
Maybe it came in afterwards, if you wanna sign, if you wanna authorize it.
I'm looking at it earlier, so. Okay. This is old.
It should be something from Colarusso, Dover. For the radio equipment.
Oh, yeah, not Kelly Anderson reimbursement check.
For another rough?
Yeah, they had two games, that would have been the last game.
It is less than $50, or $200, so I'm just gonna sign it by consensus, no sooner.
Please do.
Here it is, see the joke. Well, that's the, still is it?
Department of Revenue, once again, with Avatar. For new RSA forwarding the results of monitoring of the data that they collected. And they collected on our buildings.
You must have received preliminary because you've, you know, How close is City of Dover?
This is the old one.
This is the background. Anything else? It's the radio equipment, you know, the analog radio equipment.
Oh, yeah.
I heard from Coloruso said he had said something.
Yes, he did say it last week.
Yeah. I thought, yeah, it was 4,000.
There's another one coming for this, by the way. There's another one that's coming. That's only part of it, so.
There was a,
Oh, maybe we already signed it.
4,000 this year.
Yeah.
Starting in the fall.
Yeah, we already signed it.
I don't remember signing it, but I remember seeing it.
I remember seeing it. I will have to check the minutes.
All right, I guess we're good. Is there any public input? Charlie?
Just a general comment on Keno. You can buy tickets 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The drawings are held between 11 and 11, but they're drawn every 5 minutes. So 11:05, 11:10, instead of, I think the last meeting they said every 15 minutes.
Okay.
It's every five. Okay. Just general information.
Thank you. Anything else?
Historical committee meeting, not meeting this Thursday, the meeting next Thursday, the 1st of March. I don't know what to discuss, but one more meeting.
And I work, and we're printing flyers that will be cheaper to do here.
Yeah. At SRPC, there's a commission meeting this Thursday. It is Cynthia's last.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good question. Absolutely. Okay. Adjourned by consensus?
Yeah.
7:43.